With Pritchard on the bench, Kansas State put the clamps on Manning, and the Wildcats moved to the championship contest with a 69-54 win. The season was not over, however, as the ruling fathers of college basketball deemed Larry Brown and company worthy of competing in the NCAA tournament.
I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
Kansas opened the 64-team tournament against 18th-ranked Xavier. The Musketeers were a team which had won 26 of 29 games and featured one of the nation's leading scorers in Byron Larkin. But they were no match for the Jayhawks, as KU bolted to a 48-29 halftime lead and were never threatened in winning 85-72. The Jayhawks advanced to the second round against upstart Murray State. The game was nip and tuck as the Racers made repeated comebacks. But Manning's late-game heroics sent Kansas to the Sweet 16, winning 61-58. Kansas put its game into high gear as it traveled to Detroit for the Midwest Regional Semifinals. The Jayhawks were pitted against a balanced Vanderbilt club, which had defeated previous number one teams Kentucky and North Carolina. The matchup also featured two of the premier post players in Vandy's Will Perdue and the Jayhawks' Danny Manning. But it was Manning who stole the show as he struck for 25 first-half points as the Jayhawks streaked to a 41-29 halftime lead. A tight man-to-man defense preserved a 77-64 win and sent the Jayhawks a step closer to the Final Four.
But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruel. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race.
The regional championship game pitted the Jayhawks against cross-state rival Kansas State. The Wildcats had pulled off one of the top upsets in the nation, having defeated Purdue two nights prior in the Boilermakers' Big Ten backyard. The Sunflower State was smiling as its tradition-rich basketball sons were battling for a spot in Kansas City. Meeting for the fourth time in the season, the Jayhawks and Wildcats stood toe-to-toe throughout much of the contest. But as the clock wound down, the Jayhawks made their run for Kansas City. Clutch buckets by Danny Manning and Scooter Berry, plus a supreme defensive effort by Milt Newton, made the preseason hopes of a trip to the Final Four a reality. Excitement ran wild as the Jayhawks made their second trip to the Final Four in 3 years. Kansas would be underdogs in a field featuring national powers Duke, Arizona, and Oklahoma. But Larry Brown's Jayhawks didn't listen to those who said they shouldn't be there. Kansas semifinal contest pitted them against Duke. The game would be a rematch of the 1986 NCAA semifinal game and a contest earlier in the season in Lawrence. The eyes of the college basketball world focused on America's heartland as sudden death loomed for one team. As was the case in Lawrence in late February, the Jayhawks grabbed a big lead on the Blue Devils early. Before fans had a chance to catch their breath, Kansas had raced to an 18-2 lead. Danny Manning and Milt Newton came out of the gate quickly and were not to be denied. The Blue Devils did not roll over and began to chip away at the Jayhawk lead, but could not break the tenacious Kansas defense. With the lead cut to three, with just over 4 minutes remaining, the Jayhawks dug in and matched the Blue Devils blow for blow. Shots by Kevin Pritchard and Danny Manning, plus strong foul shooting, preserved the win. Cinderella had a date to the ball. The 1988 NCAA championship game matched Big 8 conference foes Oklahoma and Kansas. It marked only the third time in NCAA history that two teams from the same conference had met in the title game. The Sooners entered the ball game as the hottest team in college basketball. Plus, in the fact that they owned two victories over the Jayhawks earlier in the season, it was the opinion of most that Kansas' bubble would burst. With a packed Kemper Arena as the venue and millions more watching across the nation, the party of 64 had been narrowed to two. The Sooners scored the first 2 points of the evening, but the Jayhawks answered quickly. The drama began instantly in what would be one of college basketball's most memorable games. While the Sooners were noted for their high-powered run-and-gun attack, it was the Jayhawks who ran the show. Oklahoma maintained the pressure, but Kansas returned the favor by shooting 71% in the first half. While the Sooners were striking from long distance, Larry Brown orchestrated the destruction of the Oklahoma defense from inside and out. After one half of play left the teams knotted at 50 and the arena buzzing in amazement, only 20 minutes remained until a new champion would be crowned. Oklahoma maintained the pressure, but Brown rotated guards Kevin Pritchard, Jeff Geldner, Scooter Berry, Clint Normore, and Lincoln Miner in response. The Sooners were poised for the kill, but it would never come. After surrendering an early second-half lead to trail 65-60, Kansas dug down and braced itself for a comeback. While Brown was confident his Jayhawks could fight back, he was just one of many hoping the spirit of Naismith and Allen would reign that night. With the Jayhawk defense shutting the Sooners down, seniors Danny Manning and Chris Piper took control. Piper hit key buckets to thwart Sooner advances, while Manning took matters into his own hands. As the clock wound down, the Kansas defense dictated that the Sooners force some shots. Certainly Naismith and Allen were smiling now as their Jayhawks were moments away from the title. Tied at 71 with more than 6 minutes remaining, buckets by Kevin Pritchard, Danny Manning, and Chris Piper put KU up 77-71. The Sooners made one last charge, but Manning and the Jayhawks were not to be denied. Cinderella's glass slipper never fit better.
The Larry Brown Show, an inside look at KU basketball with the Jayhawks head coach, has been brought to you by All-Star Dairy, by Moppin Tour Travel Service, by the Noller Automotive Dealership, by Columbian National Bank and Trust Company, by the Holiday Inns of the Landmark Hotel Corporation, by Mainline Printing, by the Security Cash Fund, members Security Benefit Group of Companies, and by Risk International Corporation. Thank you.
when it comes to value, quality service, and low everyday prices, have Gibson's Pharmacy at 25th and Iowa fill your prescription quickly, accurately, and courteously. Bring your prescription in or have your doctor call, and let Mark or Mitch fill your next prescription. Gibson's Pharmacy, where you get discount prescriptions, patient profiles, free medical expense records, and free prescription delivery to your door. That's Gibson's Pharmacy at 25th and Iowa, where quality and low price are yours every day of the week.
FMC is the most efficient phosphate-producing facility in the industry. Only the latest equipment and technology are used. In addition, considerable effort and expense have been directed towards meeting all current environmental standards to maintain our position as a good neighbor in the community. We're people first at FMC. More than 200 employees who recognize Lawrence as a great place to live, to work, and to play. FMC, putting people and ideas to work every single day.
When we invented the first American minivan, we thought we'd see a lot of competition. But when you look around, the unequal front-wheel drive Dodge Caravan clearly stands alone. And with prices like this, no wonder it's America's best-selling family wagon. It's gotta be Dodge Caravan.
See the Dodge Caravan at Jim Clark Motors, 29th in Iowa.
Manpower Temporary Services provides exciting temporary job opportunities in Lawrence. Secretaries needing experience in office automation, Manpower offers free word processing training for temporary employees. Experienced in 10-key or cashiering, Manpower offers free data entry training for temporary employees. Manpower employees step in and produce quickly with the skills, attitude, and experience to do the job right. Call the world's largest temporary service that served Lawrence since 1977. Call Manpower at 749-2800.